疫情爆发至今，冲击最大的国家美国在经历14个月后解封了。我们专访到了大都会国际儿童事工的创办人比尔·威尔森，他曾经遭受了枪伤、刺伤，在这一次美国疫情重灾之时，人心走上了绝望。比尔牧师受邀进驻了为医院的第一线人员还有患者来祈祷，安定恐慌的心。选择了与第一线一同站立的比尔牧师，即便身穿了完善的防护衣，最终仍旧感染了新冠肺炎。牧师说，对他来说真的不好受，已经70岁不年轻了，但他靠着上帝熬了过来，而且更加的明白上帝仍在宝座上。
I don't think I was shocked because having worked in the COVID hospital and even wearing all the protective equipment, I knew that I was taking a risk. I understood that, but for those of you that are watching that know me, I'm a risk takerBecause I'm a man of faith. I believe that if I'm doing the work of the Lord, if my faith is strong, greater is he that is within me than he that is within the world. But I also knew that the need was greater than the risk that I was taking. I gave my life to Jesus and I've never looked back. So when I caught the virus, I thought, Lord, I've seen death.I've seen destruction. I've seen pain, pain that is immeasurable, almost unthinkable across this world. And yet, my faith is stronger today. When I got my throat cut in Yemen, bringing food and medicine to the children of that war-torn country, I saw Jesus there. When I got shot in the back by a Russian sniper in Syria a few years ago, and I was laying in the desert,not knowing if I would live or die. And yet I felt Jesus there. And in all the things I've been through, those have not been things that discouraged me, but they've been faith builders, that what God has done in me, through me, and with me, he can do the same thing for you.
患难是建立信仰价值的时刻。牧师在言谈间不断地展现他对神的信心，更是心系台湾，相信台湾在走出困境之时会变得更加的强大。